Let's say you want to communicate with a friend. You'd probably use a phone to send them text messages. In the same way, your brain cells communicate using neurotransmitters like acetylcholine, which plays a key role in processes ranging from memory to muscle contraction. Prompted by an electrical signal, a neuron releases acetylcholine into the synapse. Acetylcholine then binds to a receptor on the opposite neuron, relaying the signal. But what happens to acetylcholine once its job is done? Enter acetylcholinesterase, a dimeric enzyme that specializes in breaking down acetylcholine using a triad of three specific amino acids. Zooming into the active site, we can see two of these amino acids, the critical serine and the histidine, to which acetylcholine binds. With the help of a water molecule, the enzyme breaks acetylcholine down, completing the signal transmission cycle. However, as we age, the number of our cholinergic neurons decreases, leading to reduced acetylcholine levels and the onset of Alzheimer's disease. One innovative treatment for Alzheimer's involves inhibiting acetylcholinesterase with molecules like galantamine, preserving the acetylcholine in the synapse. Galantamine blocks all entry into the active site, allowing acetylcholine to continue its signal transmission unscathed. Diving into the active site, we see galantamine shutting down operation through binding to the critical serine. However, because galantamine only binds through hydrogen bonding, this inhibition is reversible. With an estimated 5.5 million Americans living with Alzheimer's, understanding the biochemistry of inhibition is a key step to bringing those numbers down. Finally, it's important for individuals consistently experiencing symptoms like confusion and memory loss to seek a medical diagnosis as soon as possible, giving their brains a head start on the path to recovery.